If you're a beginner, here's something you need to know. The programming language you choose does not matter. With hundreds of programming languages and many more frameworks, no software developer can know the syntax of every single language. You will likely work with quite a few over your time as a programmer. While the languages may all look different, the truth is they all share 90% of the same programming concept, with little quirks to each one. Once you learn these, it becomes much easier to learn new languages quickly. For this reason, the five languages I have chosen for beginners are what I believe are the five best languages to learn the general programming concepts. Once you've learned more about programming, then you can start looking at different languages for your specific interests. I used three main criteria for ranking these top five languages. The first is learning. I wanted to choose languages that teach a lot about programming and also that have easy-to-read syntax, because this allows newcomers to focus more on learning the concept and less on memorizing words. The second criteria is popularity. I wanted to choose popular languages because these ones have far more online documentation and have a lot of help available for beginners to explore. And the third criteria is career. This criteria is focused on the career outlook for the language, which includes what are the job opportunities like, how well does this language pay, and what does the future hold for this language? With that out of the way, let's get right into the list, starting off with number 5. Of all the languages on my list, C definitely has the most complex syntax and is the hardest of the 5 to learn. Think of C as being thrown into the deep end of the pool, and you can either drown or figure out a way to stay afloat. As a low-level language, C shows beginners a lot more to programming than the other languages on this list, and allows beginners to develop a fundamental understanding for how computers work. While many people encourage this style of learning, I am of the personal belief that it's better for beginners to start in the shallow end and wade their way to the deep end on their own accord. For this reason, I gave C a 2 out of 5 for the learning criteria, because while the syntax is the hardest, if beginners are able to stick with it, it definitely provides a very in-depth understanding of programming. Moving on to popularity. According to the 2021 Stack Overflow Developer Survey, C is used by about 17% of professional developers, placing it in the 12th rank for usage rates. C was also loved by 40% of developers, but dreaded by the other 60%. Finally, C has 377,944 questions on Stack Overflow, which is quite a bit less than the other languages on this list. For these reasons, I gave C a 2 out of 5 for popularity. Lastly, career outlook. According to the developer survey, just under 5% of professional developers want to learn C, placing it at 15th on the list for desire to learn. On top of this, Glassdoor estimates around $90,000 USD as an average salary for C programmers. However, C has been around for 50 years and is the base language of other languages like Python and Ruby, which, spoilers, are both on this list, making it a timeless tool. For these reasons, I gave C a 3 out of 5 for career. In contrast to C, Ruby has very simple syntax and is quite easy to use. Ruby sees its primary use in web development, paired with its full-stack web framework, Ruby on Rails. In fact, many of the world's largest tech companies started out on Ruby, including Airbnb, Hulu, and SoundCloud. On top of having very readable syntax, Ruby is object-oriented, which is one of the most important skills for beginner developers to learn. Ruby is definitely a great choice from a learning perspective, and also has a lot of practical project use, which helps with learning. The only drawback to Ruby from this criteria is that to make effective use of Ruby, you're going to need to use Ruby on Rails, which adds on an entire other framework to learn. With that as the only real drawback in this section, I gave Ruby a 4 out of 5 for learning. Moving on to popularity. Now, according to that 2021 Stack Overflow Developer Survey, Ruby is used by about 8% of professional developers and ranks 16th for usage rates. Ruby was also loved by 53% of developers and only dreaded by the other 47%. Finally, Ruby has 223,000 668 questions on Stack Overflow, which is a similar number to C and quite a bit less than the other languages on this list. For these reasons, I also gave Ruby a 2 out of 5 for popularity. Lastly, career outlook. According to that developer survey, just under 3% of professional developers want to learn Ruby, placing it at 20th on the list for desire to learn. On top of this, Glassdoor estimates around $75,000 USD as an average salary for Ruby programmers. Even though it isn't used by as very many professional developers, Ruby has a very solid community using it. Its main drawback is that in the career section the job is usually used for, web development, there are other languages that do that a bit better. For these reasons, I gave Ruby a 2 out of 5 for career. Most of you will have heard about Java, and if you haven't, consider this the first of about a million mentions in your programming career. One of the most used languages in the entire world, Java is used for various different purposes and makes up part of the back end of companies like Google, Amazon, Twitter, and YouTube. As a beginner, that should already be a strong sign to you that this is a very useful language. On top of all of that, it also has relatively simple syntax, although not the simplest, being considered a high-level language. It is also object-oriented, which, as I mentioned in the Ruby section, is a very useful skill to learn as a new developer. The only downside I can think of against Java is there are simply other programming languages that have much easier syntax and teach the same concepts. For these reasons, Java gets a 4 out of 5 for learning. Now on to our second criteria, popularity. According to the 2021 Stack Overflow Developer Survey, Java is used by about 35% of professional developers, ranking it at 7th for usage rates. Java was also loved by 47% of developers, but dreaded by the other 53%. Finally, Java has 1,841,198 questions on Stack Overflow, which is significantly higher than both C and Ruby. For these reasons, I also gave Java a 4 out of 5 for popularity. And on to our third criteria, career outlook. According to the developer survey, just under 7% of professional developers want to learn Java, placing it at around 9th on the list for desire to learn. On top of this, Glassdoor estimates around $82,000 USD as an average salary for Java programmers. As mentioned earlier, Java is used in the backbone of almost all the large tech companies in the world, and with decades of Java code in their systems, there's no chance that Java is going out of use anytime soon. For these reasons, Java also gets a 4 out of 5 in the career section. Before we get on to the top two, if you're not subscribed already, please consider subscribing. I'm still a relatively new YouTuber, and I'd really appreciate the support as I continue to create more content like this. Thanks, and let's get on to the top two. While named very similarly to Java, the languages could not be more different. JavaScript is the language of choice for front-end web development, as JavaScript is the only language, aside from HTML and CSS, if we're classifying those as languages, that runs in the browser. In fact, 97% of all pages on the internet run JavaScript. For any beginners who know they want to be web developers, you don't even need to go further in this video. JavaScript gets an instant 5 out of 5, as it's your only choice you can start with. But if you're undecided, or you just want to start off by learning about programming in general, JavaScript does have other applications than just front-end design. With a plethora of web frameworks, JavaScript can also be used in the back-end, giving it a wide variety of uses. JavaScript also has quite simple syntax, which makes it very easy to pick up for newcomers. JavaScript does have some object-oriented capabilities, but is not class-based, which is a tiny bit of a knock on it for beginners. For these reasons, JavaScript gets a 4 out of 5 for learning. Now, onto the popularity criteria. According to that same Stack Overflow developer survey, JavaScript is used by a whopping 69% of professional developers and ranks number one for usage rates. On top of this, JavaScript is the prerequisite to both TypeScript and Node.js, which are languages and frameworks that come in on 5th and 6th for usage rates on that same list. JavaScript was also loved by 62% of developers and only dreaded by the other 38%. And what's more is that its derivative that I just mentioned, TypeScript, was loved by 73% of developers and only dreaded by the other 27%. Finally, JavaScript has 2,363,127 questions on Stack Overflow, which is the highest of any language. For these reasons, I gave JavaScript a 5 out of 5 for popularity. And lastly, career outlook. According to the developer survey, around 15% of developers want to learn JavaScript, and 15% want to learn TypeScript, placing them at second and third respectively on the list for desire to learn. On top of this, Glassdoor estimates around a $75,000 USD average salary for JavaScript programmers. If you want a language that's future-proof and will be around forever, this is it. If I had to bet on one language that will be around for hundreds of years, this would be my bet. As I already mentioned, it's used in 97% of pages on the internet, and every single company has a need for JavaScript experts. For these reasons, it gets a 5 out of 5 for career. Now, JavaScript was our runner-up language with a very impressive score of 4.7 out of 5. But Python is our number one pick with a full 5 out of 5, and for good reason. Python has what is considered by most to be the easiest syntax to learn. It's used in almost anything you can think of, from web development to robotics to machine learning and artificial intelligence. It is the language for data science. Almost every single large company uses Python on the back end. It's object-oriented, and as you can tell, the list goes on and on. For being incredibly easy to learn and containing almost all of the essential programming concepts, Python gets a 5 out of 5 for learning. Moving on to popularity. Now, according to the 2021 Stack Overflow Developer Survey, Python is used by 42% of professional developers and ranks 4th for usage rates. Python was also loved by 68% of developers and only dreaded by the other 32%. Finally, Python has 1,932,349 questions on Stack Overflow, which is second only to JavaScript. For these reasons, I also gave Python a 5 out of 5 for popularity. And lastly, career outlook. According to the developer survey, 19% of professional developers want to learn Python, placing it at first on the list for most desired language to learn. On top of this, Glassdoor estimates around $90,000 USD as an average salary for Python programmers. Python is one of the fastest growing languages in the world, pays very generously compared to the other languages on this list, and is the most sought after language by developers for 2022. For these reasons, it gets a 5 out of 5 for career. Okay, so to wrap this up, here are my final thoughts. You won't go wrong choosing any one of these languages, and they're all amazing choices. If I had to recommend one language and one only, I would say Python purely because I think it's the most well-rounded and has the best balance between being easy and teaching a lot. However, many people make a case for JavaScript as a first language, which I definitely think has merit. In fact, I personally started off by taking a stab at JavaScript before I ended up ultimately switching over to Python. So don't worry about choosing wrong. You can always change, and the concepts you learn will carry over. And for those who know you're dedicated to programming and want to learn the most advanced things a beginner should learn, maybe try out C. Once you learn out C, I guarantee you'll find the other four languages in this list as a cakewalk. No matter which language you learn, the only piece of advice I have is to just stick with it. It's okay to bounce around for a little bit, but once you've tried a few, just commit to one and learn it. Chances are you'll work with at least 5 programming languages in your career, and knowing the first one makes it 1,000 times easier to learn other ones later. Thanks so much for watching. Please consider subscribing if you enjoyed this, and if you have any feedback or questions, comment them down below. I'll do my absolute best to reply to each and every comment. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.